We're living in the last days, and the reason being why we're doing this and why we teamed up to do this is because there is a revival, an end time revival coming, but it's not going to come when you're cold. It's going to come, but you're not going to be a part of it. So if you're not a part of the revival, then where are you going to be? Where are you going to be? It's like you going, and then you're working for a company, and they say we're about to change everything. It's going to be amazing. And then everyone is going for the meetings, but you're never even wanting to participate. Do you really think they're going to consider you? If you neglect God in this hour, and He's saying, I need to team up with you. Wake up. Don't look too pretty. I have a testimony of someone in here. I'm not going to say who because I love him. He says, the Holy Spirit keep waking me up at 4 a.m. And I went to bed at 2 every night. Why, Lord? Because He needs you to pray. He needs you to pray. Not just for Him, but for your life. We're going to worship, but tonight, look at your neighbor and say, I'm glad you came. Glad you came. Surprise, surprise. We're going to do some nice things tonight. I want you to posture yourself. Tonight you came here. And I want us to limit every distraction in this house. Limit it. Because we're on a serious assignment tonight. Last night it was awesome. We consecrated our own selves. Everyone. Once again. Just like David said, God, I'm going to give myself first before I can even bring anyone else. But guess what? Tonight we're going to consecrate the entire house. So what we're going to do, bring the oil and put on the altar. At some point of time, I'm going to have everyone participate. We're going to anoint your hands, and we're going to pray through this house, every place in the sanctuary. And I suggest those of you who are watching, do the same in your house. Because when God is ushering in a new glory, you want Him to come and you want the glory to sit in the house. Because for too long now, the enemy has been coming and taking the Ark of the Covenant out. And we have allowed him to take it this place and that place and this place and that place. So now when people are coming into the houses, and I'm not saying this, but this is, we're using this house as a point of contact for all the other houses. Because God told us to do this. But a lot of churches and a lot of leaders, a lot of pastors, a lot of generals are watching us now. So we have to make sure that we are all on one accord. So what the enemy is doing is saying, okay, I'm going to do everything I can to distract these people so that God knows, because God does not dwell where there's no pure thing. You understand? He's holy. So He will do everything so that the glory does not stay. So the glory will come, but it will leave. But once you consecrate the house and you apply the oil and the blood and say, Lord, we close. Remember when I was teaching a few days ago, every gap, every access, and we want to see how He's going to come back on the inside and take what belongs to us. We will never ever, because when you come in a place where the glory is, I'm gonna talk to you guys about a man named Jehoshaphat. You're gonna understand. First, let us worship. Father, you're awesome, you're mighty in this house. You are glorious. You reign. You reign. You reign, God. There's nobody like you. There's nobody like you, God. We give you this service. We thank you for the leaders of this house. We thank you for the people that you love so much. God, we thank you, oh God, even for those who are not here. We thank you for them, oh God. We thank you that their lives are kept safe in you. We thank you for the love and the unity in this place. Oh, come on, worship Him. We thank you, oh God, for the miracles that take place, oh God. Not just in this house, but through this ministry, oh God. Hey, every seed, oh God. We thank you, oh God, that is bringing forth much fruit, oh God. Hey, glory, 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 glory. Glory, 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 oh God. We thank you for every man, high. Hallelujah, that has mounted the stage, oh God, the pulpit, oh God, and has taught the word of God. We thank you, oh God, for every friend of the ministry. We ask you to bless your people. We worship you in this place. We give you this house once again, oh God. Have your way. Take full control, oh God. God, let it be your house, oh God, forever, oh God. Put a seal on it, oh God. And put a stamp on it, oh God. And say, today this is my house. That there will be no more hurt, no more tears in this place. The joy of the Lord will be in this house, oh God. There will be no more lack. The thief should not come back in. Thank you, oh God, for the teachings on the angels, oh God, in this house. And we thank you that right now they are charged. Because your mouthpiece, oh God, your manservant has spoken, oh God. We thank you, oh God, that they are activated. 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 They are activated. I activate you, angels. Come on, activate your angels. Come on. We activate and disactivate every fallen angel. Disactivate every disobedient angel. God, arise. Lord, arise and scatter your enemies. Every enemy of the gospel. Hallelujah, we claim your souls, oh God. We claim for those souls to come back. Come home. Come back. Those souls in Hollywood. Those souls in Africa, oh God. They all belong to you in Asia. Yes. Come on, saints. We claim for those souls in Rhode Island. Oh God, in Johnston, oh God. In Boston, oh God, in New York, oh God, we claim for those souls, hallelujah. In Houston, oh God, in Maryland, oh God, in DC, oh God, we claim for those souls in Atlanta, oh God, oh God. It's a revival, oh God, the revival, oh God, of souls, hallelujah, being won into the kingdom, oh God. Revival, revival, we cry out, Lord, send forth your revival. Father, we understand what you're saying in this place. Jesus, you alone are exalted. It is you doing this, oh God. No man shall take the glory for your work. Maya. Yes, oh God, glorify your name, glorify yourself in this place. We want to get out of the way and let you shine. Oh, yes, yes, no flesh will exalt itself in this place, no idol, no other God except for Jesus, except for Jesus. Only you, Lord. Delight yourself in us, oh God. Only you, Lord. Take pleasure in this place. Only you, Lord. Only you, Lord. Show us the way, oh God. Only you, Lord. Lead us and guide us, Lord. Only you, Lord. Come and teach us. Show us the way. The words of our mouth and the meditations of our heart be acceptable in thy sight, oh Lord, our strength and our redeemer. Only you, Lord. Only you, Lord. Only you, Lord. Only you, Lord. Show us your heart in this place. Only you, Lord. Give us your mind in this house. Only you, Lord. Only you, Lord. Oh, by your might, oh God, by your power, by your spirit, oh God, deliver your people. Only you, Lord. God, anything at all that was holding back the testimonies of your people. Jesus. Let it be removed. Every hindrance. Every spirit of sabotage. Every familiar spirit. Every limitations on the people, it's removed. Every spirit of headache, every oppression in the mind, you go. Let their ears be open now to hear your voice, Lord. We're not coming here so that we can show how well we can do this, oh God. But we humble ourselves under your mighty hand. That you be exalted. Show up and show out your glory. Give your people a deeper taste, a hunger and an appetite for you. Every spirit of stubbornness, we paralyze you in the mighty name of Jesus. Spirit of doubt, spirit of fear, Second Chronicle, verse chapter 20. It happened after this that the people of Moab with the people of Ammon, others with them, besides the Ammonite, came to battle against Jehoshaphat. Then some came and told Jehoshaphat, saying, a great multitude is coming against you from beyond the sea, from Syria, and they are in Hazazon Tamar, which is En-Gedi. And Jehoshaphat feared and set himself to seek the Lord, and proclaimed the fast throughout all Judah. So Judah gathered together to ask help from the Lord. And from all the cities of Judah, they came to seek the Lord. Then Jehoshaphat stood in the assembly of Judah and Jerusalem in the house of the Lord before the new court, and said, O Lord God, our fathers, are you not God in heaven? And do you not rule over all the kingdoms of the nations? And in your hand, is there not power and might, so that no one else is able to withstand you? Are you not our God who drove out the inhabitants of this land before your people, Israel, and gave it to the descendants of Abraham, your friend, forever? I want you to see yourself in this scripture. I want you to look at yourself. Because you are right now from the tribe of the Lord, the tribe of Judah. You are mighty and victorious, but at times the enemy will come to test you, to test the word that's on the inside. And every day, reason why we're doing 21 days, again, we are saying that there is a pattern here that we need to break. Because the last thing we want to do is to start, and then for the first 5 days, you're back up, and then we stop. And then we just quiet everything, and we just focus on, you know, God, give me nation, give me money, give me those. And then on the day 10, he comes back and he sneaks up on you and you forget. No, we're gonna break that pattern. Amen. And we are following. Amen. And he said, verse 8, and they dwell in it and have built you a sanctuary in it for your name, saying, if disaster comes upon us, sword, judgment, pestilence, or famine, we will stand before this temple and in your presence, for your name is in this temple, and cry out to you in our affliction, and you will hear and save. Verse 10 says, and now here are the people of Ammon. They were talking to God, they were praying. They were communicating with the Lord what was going on. And saying, here are these people, the Ammon, Moab, and Mount Sire, whom you would not let Israel invade when they came out of the land of Egypt, but they turned from them and did not destroy them. Here they are rewarding us by coming to throw us out of your possession, which you have given us to inherit. Are you following what this scripture is trying to show to you? Because I guarantee you, there's not one person in this place yet. I have given the testimony that I have recovered all. Is there one? We must recover all. If you say you're gonna recover all, you're gonna recover all. Verse 12. He says, "Oh our God, will you not judge them? For we have no power against this great multitude that is coming against us. Nor do we know what to do, but our eyes are upon you." You have to understand that he's here. I want you to understand that this is not man we're talking about, because we wrestle not against flesh and blood. So never ever under any circumstance look at yourself like, "I'm fighting against my neighbor." Your neighbor is not your problem. It's the spirit that came upon them, or that is using them, without sometimes even without them knowing. Sometimes even with your children, can we be honest? They associate themselves with people in school, and then they come and they become stubborn all of a sudden. They don't listen to you. Have you experienced that, mothers? You have? Yeah, let us be truthful. The Bible says he's the spirit of truth. If the church is not truthful, let me tell you, the world is truthful. They don't bite their words, except the church. Saints, let us just be cool. We're not going to be cool no more. I'm telling you, y'all, I'm awoke. Tired of being a slave. Well, they're riding my horse. The devil is alive. Get out of there. Thank you. So, I'm saying is, some spirits will jump upon people around you. So not even just you, but people around you. And then you begin to look at them like, "But this is someone that I know. Why on earth are you acting funny all of a sudden?" So God is saying, I'm teaching you how to win the battle when it comes against you. So you're not hating your neighbor. You're not hating your husband or your wife or your children. But you can dissect. You can see the enemy for who he is. And even without hurting them and them knowing, you can just say, "I call that thing out." You just walk. Do you understand? Because you don't want people feeling like they're the demon. But there is a spirit in the land that does not want us, the children of God, to rule. There are strongholds. They are there. They don't sleep. We sleep. They don't sleep. They're charged for this. They have given their lives, their blood. They say, "We're going to make sure that they go down." So the people of that time, what they were saying is that, "God, we did not even do anything to them." Because most of the time, Christians don't go looking for trouble. Do y'all believe that, right? We don't go looking for war. But they always come against you. I'm saying this lie. Yes. They always come against you. And you're quiet and you're peaceful and you're blessing the land. You're blessing your neighbors. There's always someone, the devil. So what God is saying, you have, just like those people, you have to say it. Say, "God, I don't like what's going on." Because if you don't open your mouth and say it, he's not going to move. He's going to be like, "Okay, I guess maybe you like where you are. You like how things are. So who am I to come and interrupt your pretty life?" If you want to keep living in that one bedroom apartment, who am I to come and give you a mansion? Who am I? But you must say, no. When I'm in this apartment, my neighbors, they don't like when I pray. They don't like when I'm worshiping. I can't be loud. I can't even have people over. I can do what I want. I'm in prison. No, you're not in really prison. But you understand what I'm saying. You're like, "God, I want to own my own. I want to be in my own place. I want to own the land. I can own some land." I have friends who have a lot of lands. And they're enjoying themselves. Yes. So why would God give or do for one and not do for all? He's no respecter of a person. But those people, they understood what was coming against them and said, "No, you're going to back off. You're not going to disturb my peace." It says, oh God, will you not judge them? For we have no power against this great multitude that is coming against us. Nor do we know what to do, but our eyes are upon you. Now all Judah, with their little ones, their wives, and their children, stood before the Lord. Verse 14, then the Spirit of the Lord came upon Jehazel, the son of Zechariah, the son of Benaiah, the son of Jael, the son of Mattaniah. These people have really some nice names. Jesus, Father, my children will have easy names. A Levite of the sons of Asaph in the midst of the assembly. And he said, listen, all you of Judah and you inhabitants of Jerusalem, and you King Jehoshaphat, thus says the Lord to you, do not be afraid or dismayed because of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but God's. He says, tomorrow go down against them. God is saying, that's why he said, wake up and pray, because I got your back. Let them try you. I got you. God says, I can take them out. Just one hand, I can just wipe them. Like back then with Noah. Remember when he was building the ark and everybody thought he was funny? At 500 years old, the Lord told Noah to build the ark. I'm sure everyone was like, you are crazy. He's like, okay, I'm going to get my house ready. Since you think I'm crazy with my old self. Since you are young and you want to keep partying. Okay, you go ahead and party. When the flood came, what happened? I'm sure they were like, Noah, save us. And he's like, bye-bye. But that's not you guys. You guys are nice. You would definitely open the door. God says, close the doors and the windows. They did not want to fight the enemy. Sorry, y'all. I love you. I'm just saying what the Bible says. Just the Bible. Now, verse 16 says, tomorrow go down against them. They will surely come up by the ascent of Ziz, and you will find them at the end of the brook before the wilderness of Jericho. Remember what God says. God will show you where they are located. He will show you, okay, there is an enemy who has been sitting on your chest. And that's why you've been having that pain. And you've been praying for healing, but you don't know there's something that you have to renounce. Or maybe there's a connection with it. Back then, maybe your great-great-great-grandparents were suffering with this same thing. He will just show you, and it will be easy. Because sometimes we come to the house of the Lord and we go to the man or the woman of God, pray for us, nothing is happening. Then you become so discouraged, like God is not even real no more. But he said, I will show you. He's letting them know exactly where the enemy are positioned. Verse 17, you will not need to fight this battle. Just position yourselves. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord who is with you. Oh, Judah and Jerusalem. Do not fear or be dismayed. Tomorrow, go out against them, for the Lord is with you. And Jehoshaphat bowed his head and his face to the ground. And all Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem bowed before the Lord, worshiping the Lord. Something happens when you worship. It just shifts the atmosphere. Then God says, okay, now your spirit is charged. After you worship, what you gonna do? After you are charged, what you gonna do? Because now your machine gun, spirit, people, in the spirit, I bind that spirit. I'm going buying guns. I have to say this. I'm not gonna say it. Some people are like, yep, I'm gonna go buy a gun tomorrow. No. Your spiritual weapons will be charged, so you will be positioned to shoot it. You people that are watching, pray for us. We are ready for this. Already. And then the Levites of the children of the Kohathites and of the children of the Korahites, Father, help these people. And of the children of the Korahites stood up to praise the Lord God of Israel with voices loud and high. So verse 20 says, they rose early in the morning and went out into the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went out, Jehoshaphat stood and said, hear me, O Judah, and you inhabitants of Jerusalem. Believe in the Lord your God and you shall be established. Believe his prophet and you shall prosper. And when he had consulted with the people, he appointed those who should sing to the Lord and those who should praise the beauty of his holiness. As they went out before the army and were saying, praise the Lord, for his mercy endures forever. Now when they began to sing and to praise, the Lord set ambushes against the people of the Hemon, the Moab, and the Mount Sire, who had come against them, Judah, and they were defeated. For the people of Ammon and Moab stood against the inhabitants of Mount Sire. So guess what? The enemy, what God is going to do is...
Y'all, let me just finish the scripture. Okay, let me just finish this verse,
and I'm going to tell you guys what I just... Okay, so of Mount Sire to utterly kill and destroy them. And when they had made an end of the inhabitants of Sire, they helped to destroy one another. And so pretty much what you're going to be doing, you're going to be praising the Lord and anointing yourself and saying, I'm brand new, and all of this awesome stuff that you're going to be seeing in the house of the Lord. And what God is going to do is everyone who came against you, now what they're going to do is they're going to turn against each other. And they're going to finish each other for you. Now you ought to praise God for that. Listen, don't be clapping if you're thinking about your neighbor. Don't be, because you know I'm a pro, I can see. They're talking about spirits. That means the spirit of lies is going to talk to the spirit of anger and say, I don't like you either. And they're just going to say, because God can do that. God created all things, and he can do just that for you. If he did it back then, and Jesus hadn't even died on the cross back then, and now you even got the blood to call upon, the blood of the Lamb that prevails against all things. So when Judah came to a place overlooking the wilderness, they looked towards the multitude, and there were their dead bodies fallen on the earth. No one had escaped. When Jehoshaphat and his people came to take away their spoil, they found among them an abundance of valuables on the dead bodies, and precious jewelry, which they stripped off from themselves, more than they could carry away. And they were there for 3 days gathering the spoil, because there was so much that the enemy left behind. Remember the testimony that a woman said yesterday? You guys remember who was here last night? About, I think her name is Brown, something like that. She was giving God glory for all these awesome things, healing and all these awesome things and deliverance that God was doing for her. And she's been watching us every day. But then also she said she wanted to sow a seed. We were talking about consecrating ourselves and making sure that we don't break our vows. So then she said that she was looking for a seed to sow. Not much, but just something to be great, to say, God, I'm thankful for this. You know, it came to my house. I didn't have to go out there looking for it. But she said she had no money. That out of nowhere, because of her heart, God provided the money in her bank account. But it's because of these prayers, breaking all these things. Now the enemy will leave behind everything he stole. Everything he took from you. You can just go places and they'll be like, did you apply for a car? Remember the story you told me about the car? You're not even applying for anything. You're not even asking for anything, and they're just handing it over to you. They're promoting you at a work that you're trying to quit. You're getting ready to give in your letter. Yes, I know that I'm talking to some people. You're about to give in your letter, and they're like, oh well, we were thinking about promoting you, you know. And you're like, I'm trying to leave y'all. Let me tell you something. These blessings will run you over. It will overtake you. You will be like, what in the world is going on in my life? But that's what's going to happen once you break those things. Yes. If it's in the Bible, I didn't write it. Why would he put it there? It says, and on the fourth day, they assembled in the valley of Baraka. For there they blessed the Lord. Therefore, the name of that place was called the Valley of Baraka, the Valley of Blessings, until this day. Then they returned, every man of Judah and Jerusalem, with Jehoshaphat in front of them, to go back to Jerusalem with joy. God is going to make this house a house of joy. By the time I'm done and I leave this place, I know I'm going to be getting phone calls of lives of being changed and transformed. There's nothing that makes me happy like seeing people prosper. I have a serious issue where people are broke and are suffering and are sick. I'm so sorry, everybody that knows me, people are under me, they know I have a serious, I take it personally. It's like it becomes my own battle. Like I don't got no, you understand? I don't like it. Like I will take you down to my last drop. And I'm talking about drop of blood. I don't like to smell the enemy. So I will take it upon myself.
Yeah.
You gotta get bold for the Lord. You ain't got nothing to be scared about. God's gonna back you up. If what you're doing is right, He's gonna back you up. If what you're doing is wrong with the wrong motives, He's gonna say, move out of the way. Just move, just move, just move. Then they return every man, and they rejoiced over their enemies. Verse 28, so they came to Jerusalem with stringed instruments and harps and trumpets to the house of the Lord. And the fear of God was on all the kingdoms of those countries when they heard that the Lord had fought against the enemies of Israel. Then the realm of Jehoshaphat was quiet, and his God gave him rest all around. Your enemies will come praise you. Your neighbors will come and say, what happened in this place? A revival broke out in Toronto years ago. A group of people came together and they said they're going to start ripping off, well, not ripping, but praying over every page of the phone book. So they knew they could not just raise up prayers, because I don't know about that time, because it was way, way, way back, if they were allowed to do that together. But they used strategic prayers. So what they did is, it was a bunch of people come together and pray. And I don't think it was just one church. So they began to pray over every page of the book, the phone book. After that, till today, I'm from Canada. I know this. Toronto is one of the greatest places where, like, you can feel the presence of God is moving in that place. Till today, you can still see that God indeed was in that thing. We're saying this to say, wake up, wake up, wake up. Nobody's going to take the plunder for you. Nobody's going to take it for you. So I want you all to come and consecrate yourself. What we're going to do is we're going to clean the place. Because before God can come in and begin to say, okay, now I have appointed you to do so. Okay, this love, unite, everything has to be put in order. Amen? So we're going to do this as a point of contact. Those of you who are watching, I suggest you do it in your house, because we're not going to be facing the camera unless the camera follows us, but we're going to be anointing. When I say everything, even the tissues. You think I'm playing? You must not know about my prayer life. Everything will be anointed. That when someone come here, you sneeze, they healed. You just sneeze, they get their healing. You look at them, they're delivered. So you will not need to have on a show all the time. Not saying that there is a show here, but I'm just saying, when I talk about church in general, it is evident and it has been proven by even those who have left the body that we are in a place where we are too comfortable. And you can't help nobody when you're too comfortable. And you're just sitting there and the enemy keeps coming. And then when he knows you're down, he's going to keep punching you. And no, in this house, we don't just focus on the enemy. I just want to make it clear. But there is a season for everything. The effective prayers of the righteous availeth much. Though there's love in this house, we want to make sure that we are not short of anything at all. When it comes to God's house, and when you come through the doors, you are feeling the glory so much that, oh my shit. Have you ever been to a place when you come in, the glory so thick that you can't even keep your shoes on? I know I've been to places like that. You're like trembling. I mean, when you come in and you didn't even say hello to someone, or you're angry at someone, the glory just arrests you like, did you say hello? And you're like, sorry, Jesus. Yes, hello, how are you? God just told me to tell you hello. The glory will make you do that. Unless we don't want to do it, then God can just pass us by and say, I'll go to the house the next door and I'll just do my own thing there. Unless we don't want to do it. But are we all on one accord? Are we all on board? If we are, let us all come forth, including myself. Please give me the oil. We're all going to anoint ourselves, and we're all going to be walking in my shoes, my comfortable shoes in the back. Yes, we are removing the heels.
I told you my prayer life is not a joke. Yes.
Thank God for you. Keep bringing in your prayer requests. We will pray over them afterwards. We will declare some awesome things over you. God is here and is moving. Just do this. Consecrate yourself, your house. We gave our houses first, which is our bodies, last night. And now we're going to give a physical body to the Lord. Somebody. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we release your glorious power against the enemy in this house. According to Exodus 15:6, let the power and might of the Lord be released from your hand, Lord. According to 1 Chronicles 29:12, scatter the enemy by your power. According to Psalm 59:11, rule over your enemies through your power. According to Psalm 66:7, as you are here, begin to worship before we anoint our hands. It says, let your power, hallelujah, the power of your anger be released against the powers of darkness. According to Psalm 90:11, I release the power and the authority of the Lord against all demons we have encountered in the name of Jesus. According to Matthew 10:1, God, we are delivered from the power of Satan unto God. According to Acts 26:18. Divide the sea and destroy marine spirits through your power. According to Job 26:12. We are strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. According to Ephesians 6:10. Father, cause the powers of darkness to submit to your power. Display your awesome power that man will believe. Release your power in healing and deliverance. According to Luke 5:17. Release your powerful voice, God. According to Psalm 29:4. Come on, worship him as you're hearing his prayers. Let us be amazed at your power. According to Luke 9:43. Oh God, let great power be released through your apostles in this place. According to Acts 4:33. Come on, saints, pray. Let signs, wonders, and miracles be released through the power of the Holy Spirit in this house. According to Romans 15:19. Let us preach and teach with demonstration of the Spirit and power. According to 1 Corinthians 2:4. Let your power work through us. According to Ephesians 3:20. God, we thank you. Release your powerful angels on our behalf to fight our battles in the heavens. Oh, according to 2 Peter 2:11 and Revelation 18:1. Release the power of Elijah through your prophets in this house. According to Luke 1:17. Let us be willing in the day of your power. According to Psalm 110:3. And God, we just gonna release your arm, oh God. Your arm that fights for us. Come on, begin to call upon the blood. Begin to call upon the blood. No one, hallelujah, has an arm like you, Lord. Your arm is full of power and might. According to Job 49, Lord, you have a mighty arm. Your arm is strong and your right hand is high. According to Psalm 89:13, stretch out your arm and deliver us. Rid us of all the bondages. According to Exodus 6:6, oh God, let fear and dread fall upon the enemy by the greatness of your arm until we pass over. According to Exodus 15:16, favor us, oh God. Favor us, oh God. And let your right arm bring us into our possession. According to Psalm 44:3, break Rahab in pieces and scatter the enemies with your strong. Come on, people, pray. I don't hear you. With your strong arm. According to Psalm 89:10, Lord, let your hand establish us and let your arm strengthen us. According to Psalm 89:21, Lord, your right hand and your holy arm gives us victory. According to Psalm 98:1, shoot lightning down your arm against the enemies. According to Isaiah 30:30, Father, we trust in your arms for our salvation. According to Isaiah 51:5, awake, awake and put on strength, O arm of the Lord. Awake as in the ancient days, like Rahab, wound the dragon. According to Isaiah 51:9, make bare your holy arm in the sight of all the nations, and let our flesh see your salvation, God. According to Isaiah 52:10, Show strength with your arm and scatter the proud. According to Luke 1:51, reveal your arm to us that we might know your strength and your power. Let your power, hallelujah, let the power, oh God, of your hands be released over our lives. According to Habakkuk 3:4, ora ba 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 shake it sata eka ta 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 ta. Come on, pray. We release the blood everywhere in this place. We'll cook this whole house with the blood, even to the basement. God, as we consecrate our hands with fresh oil, Father, you said it's the anointing that is showing the yoke. Let your unction come upon us, oh God, to give us power over the enemy and everything it took. For your house, oh God, will fight for us, oh God. In this house, oh God, there is provisions, oh God. There is breakthrough. There is salvation. There is deliverance. There is healing, miracles, healing for the nations, oh God. We take it all. We take it in the name of Satan and the Mosata. Father, anoint this oil. Come on, keep praying the blood. Keep calling on the blood. The blood all over the children. Nothing at all will harm them. Come on, come on. Hallelujah, thank you, Lord God. These are now your hands.
Jesus, pray. Hey, God. Jesus. Hey, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. She and the boy kete. Rakata and the boy kete. Yeah, God. Jesus. Glory. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Fire of the Holy Ghost. Fire of the Holy Ghost. Shake it in our boy, kept it. Rakato, rip it, kept it our boy. Shake it and our boy, kept it. Rapato, our boy, and our boy. Shiko, and our boy, kept it. Shakoto, rapakata, our boy. Jesus. Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh God, we give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Your glory, oh God. Your glory, oh God. Release your power in this place, oh God. Release your fire in this place, oh God. Your consuming fire of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Shake it in our boy, kete. Rapa kata na boye ke shamba na boye na boye kotora na boye Jesus shamba kata na boye ke sukotora na boye Jesus Jesus, 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 Jesus. Open heaven in this place, oh God. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Rabba ba 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 ba. Jesus, Jesus, open heaven, oh God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hey. She come on, lay hands on everything and declare, decree and declare. Okay, I didn't do her. The glory of God is resting in this house. Every idol, everything that's not of God, leaves the house of the Lord. Never comes back. Come on, cover the walls. Cover the doors. Come on, come on, cover the windows. Everybody, come on, come on, come on. Consecrate the house. Consecrate the house. Close all the gaps. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, consecrate the house. Say this house is yours. Come on the carpet. On the doorposts. Come on the windows. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Consecrate the house. Consecrate the house. No weapon formed against this place shall be able to prosper. We consecrate it. We consecrate it. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, give God this place. Re-pa-pa-pa-pa-pa. We sanctify it. We cover it. This house belongs to Jesus. It is glorified. Hallelujah. The sick are healed in this place. The anointing of God rests in this house. Revival in this place. We go for revival. The souls will come from everywhere. Every chair will be filled. There will be an overflow in the house. There will be an overflow in the house. All too much overflow running over is coming. Everything in the way of God's move, we command you to go. The blood is against you. The blood is against you. Lord, your blood everywhere. Your blood everywhere. Your blood everywhere. Your blood everywhere. Your blood. Your blood. Your blood. Every book will be sold. Every city will be heard. Hey, your blood over the ceiling. Your blood. Come on, man. Let's go down. Let's go to the basement. Reka pa 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 pa. Your blood. Reka ya ba 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 ba. Shake it, le le le. Everything here, we consecrate to Jesus, to Jesus, to Jesus. He is the first, he is the king in this place. Jesus, you reign. Take over, take over, take over. Holiness, faithfulness. No division, no discord, no hunger. There is provision in this place. Healing, deliverance. The joy of the Lord is in this place. We thank you that this place is filled with souls. We thank you for the overflow. We thank you, oh God, this house is yours. We are billionaires in this house. No one lacks in this house. In the name of Jesus, God, we activate the angels. Take over, watch over this house, day and night. Take over, watch over this house, day and night. Come on, rain your blessings. Rain it, rain it. The ceilings, under the rooftops. God, no more access to the enemy. He will not play tricks. He will not even peep through. He will not know the blessings that God has for us. No! Everything here belongs to Jesus. There will be no struggle. There will be no struggle. There will be no struggle. No one will be on welfare in this house. No one will be on welfare in this house. No one. We will not depend on the government. We will not depend on the government for food. Come on, come on. Where's the oil? Deliver us in this place. In the name of Sheke. In the name of Jesus. Mighty men, mighty women are being raised up in this place. Mighty revival. Mighty revival. Every document in this house. Taxes. Favor with the government. Favor. There will be no lack. There will be no debt. In the name of Jesus. Everything that's not of God moves. Leaves. Now. Now. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Father, you will answer the prayers of your people. You will back it up. Every idol goes. Everything that was hidden goes. Oh God, we expose it. Give me the oil. We expose it. We expose it. God, your glory will chase it away. Your glory will chase the Satan away. And his demons will no longer prevail. There will be no confusion in the house. There will be no confusion in the house. Hallelujah. 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 Mighty revival. Testimonies. 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 The strength of God in this place. The strength of God in this place. Oh, anyone who comes here with the wrong spirit will submit, will surrender to our God. Oh, for the spirit of the Lord is here. The breakthrough of God lives in this place. Oh, ba 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 she. Oh, ba 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 she. Oh, pa 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 pa. Every gift of God that comes to this house is consecrated. Every gift, every gift. Ah, there will be no thieves in this house. When we're not here, the angels are watching over this house day and night. When we're not in the building, the angels are watching day and night, over every instrument, over every equipment, the blood, over the cameras, lives are being transformed. Hey, yes, Lord. Hey, where's the oil? No one will be weak in this place. We come against the spirit of fatigue. We come against the spirit of fatigue. We break it off of the lives of people. Give me oil. Only mighty men and mighty women in this house. Oh, no one will be weak. No one will be left behind. Great teachers in this house. Great apostles in this house. Great prophets in this house. Everyone comes here. The Spirit of God. We quicken the mortal bodies. Everyone who comes here. The Spirit of God. Will sharpen their gifts. Everyone that comes here. The Spirit of God. Will cause them to prosper. Everyone that comes here. God, everyone who comes against us, oh God. You will fight for us. 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 Every light in this place, light up like the glory. Jesus all over this place. Jesus all over this place. The Holy Ghost all over this place. Let's go in the back. Come on, let's go in the back in the office. Every room. Overflow. Glory, 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 glory. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We break off every curse that was spoken over your people. We break it off. We break it off. We break it off. God, this house is blessed. Ah, this house is blessed. It's mighty. It's mighty. It's mighty. It's mighty. No one will come against your people anymore. Nothing will stand in the way. Nothing, nothing, oh Lord. Hey, hey, come on, praise it. Pray, 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 pray. Pray, yes, Lord. Raise them up. Wake them up. Father, no more. They are mighty in God. They are strong in God. Glorious. Every guy, every girl that comes to this house that wants to submit. Father, I thank you for the spirit of submission. I thank you for the spirit of willingness or of obedience upon them. Every man and every woman that comes to this place. Father, I thank you. There will be no struggle. Hallelujah. In tapping into the glory, into the anointed that in this place, every book in this house that is read brings us to another level. Holy Spirit, clear up every glass, everything, oh God. We give you everything. Hey! Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, yeah, yeah. Break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain. Every spirit of stubbornness, you go. Every idolatry, we bind you and rebuke you. Hey, break the glory, the glory, the glory, the glory, the glory, the glory, the glory. Come on, pray. Proceed. You've already done this. Every man servant, every woman who comes here with the heart of serving, enemy will not play with our mind. Every hallelujah puppet, every gift that comes to other men, other women, God Jesus, it is consecrated. It is consecrated. Every offering, every camera, eka pa 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 pa, eka pa 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 pa, eka pa 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 pa. We clean up everything, oh God. Every purse, every shoes, every coat, every speaker. Ekayana na bosete, ekayana na bosete, yekana bosete. Every TV in this place, every project in this place, will go forward. Will go forward. Yemana washeke na na bosata. The songs of the Lord, the Spirit of God, the songs of the Lord, the Spirit of God, the songs of the Lord, the Spirit of God. Ekanele na bosate. Supernatural strength upon your people, supernatural power upon your people, grace upon your people, more grace upon your people, love, love in the midst, greater voice, greater power, greater anointing, multiple income, and more streams of income to provide their needs. I declare it. This pulpit, this place is consecrated. It's consecrated. It's consecrated. Ekaya baba 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 shete. Ekaya ba oba papa papa. Come on, keep. Tap the carpet. Ayayayayayayayayayayabo shete. Ekaya nana bosaye. Ekaya nana bosaye. Ekaya baba baba. God, we worship you in this place. We worship you, oh God. We worship you, oh God. We break every assignment of the enemy against the prosperity of your people, against their finances, oh God, in this house. Hallelujah. 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 Ah, yeah, 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 yeah. Ah, yeah, 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 yeah. Ah, yeah, 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 yeah. Ah, yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, andelelelele bosaya. Oh, andelelele bosaya. Oh, ande. Where's brother? Where's brother Blake? Where is he? Come on, brother Blake. Come on. Come on, you saints are still praying.
We're just gonna pray. If it's caught up in the spirit, come, Ethan, come. Ethan, come, baby. Come, ba-ba-ba-ba-ba, shete. Come on, keep praying. Oh, God. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God, you're in this place. Let your will prevail. Come on, my brother. You're just going to pray over these prayers for the prosperity and the financial release of the people.
All assignments of the enemy against my finances in the name of Jesus. I thank you that as we operate, that we don't just look for money, but for a total and complete encompassing prosperity in every aspect of our life. I break all curses of poverty, lack, debt, and failure in the name of Jesus. What we've done before, even if you faced it before and it has not come out your way, I thank you that today that you have a new story. You will have success. Even in the things that you may have tried for years and years, because I thank God for a new revelation on how to operate. I seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness and all things that are added unto me. Matthew 6:33. Seek first the kingdom of God. Make it your priority. Don't add or make other things that you feel are important an equal priority. You set first the kingdom and then everything falls into line. We don't have to live trying to make things be in line. They become in line when you subject them to the one who has all things subjected to him. I rebuke and cast out all spirits of the cankerworm, palmerworm, caterpillar, and locust that would eat up my blessings in the name of Jesus. Joel 2:25. There shall be no sicknesses. There shall be no plagues. Where things that come into your house that penetrate and just rest upon you or people you know. All those things today in the name of Jesus are dead. Lord, teach me to profit and lead me in the way I should go. Isaiah 48:17. I thank you, Lord, that we profit not in just financial things, but in wisdom, in relationships, in the quality of our love. You are Jehovah Jireh, my provider. Genesis 22:14. Provider. It doesn't say what he provides, but he provides all things good. Specifically, not in this verse. He is a provider of anything you need. So why is it that we would ever go to close friends that we've been born with to get answers? No one knows you better than your creator. And trust me, if he's faithful to take you in, he will keep you. You are El Shaddai, the God of more than enough. See, we don't just pray to have our needs met. We pray for surplus, for overflow, that you don't have profit until you have more than you start with. Wealth and riches are in my house, in our house, because we fear you and delight greatly in your commandments. Psalm 112:1-3. And his commandments only work towards our good. So we find joy in finding out what works in our life. And if that hasn't been the case, if it's been a chore to follow the word of God, I pray that today it becomes easy through revelation of what it's doing for you and for those around you. The blessing of the Lord upon my life makes me rich, makes us rich, makes us expand and expound, find new words, new ways to reach, to touch, to teach. I am blessed coming in and blessed going out. It doesn't matter whether I arrive or I leave. You will feel my impact. You will feel our impact because of the spirit that we carry in us. I thank you, Lord, that we can't be in a place and there not be change. And even if we've come into a place and it seems like people don't receive us anymore, I thank you that that's turned around right now. I am God's servant, and he takes pleasure in my prosperity, in our prosperity. We are God's servants. Psalm 35:27. Not just servants like a slave, but through joy and understanding, we gladly, knowing what our decisions will bring, we gladly choose not to make it a sacrifice, but a privilege to serve. Jesus, you became poor, that through your poverty I might become rich. 2 Corinthians 8:9. And tonight, we thank you, Jesus, for relinquishing your spot, even temporarily. Just, I know in my life that even a temporary disconnect from God makes all the difference in my day. Jesus, that you could do it with the revelation that you had, I don't understand. I don't understand what you gave up, but I understand how much I think my life is precious and those around me that I love. So I thank you for your selflessness. I meditate on the word day and night, and whatever I do prospers. Psalm 1:3. I meditate on the word day and night. Day and night, not even about sunset, sunrise, but no matter when I wake up and when I go to sleep, that I will have prosperity. Even if it just comes down to writing down my plans, to set out my day, I thank you that I successfully do things that make sense, that we make sense of what we do. Let peace be within my walls and prosperity within my palace. Psalm 122:7. Let there be peace. Without peace, without order in our household, how do we function? How do we operate? Even as simple as something being lost can cause distress. I thank you that nothing's lost, and that whatever wasn't in order in our houses, in our lives, in our minds, is all set. Set in line with the word. I will prosper through the prophets and prophetic ministry. Ezra 6:14. I thank you for those who I can trust to be delivered the word, to respond in like and send word to us. I thank you that there's people in our lives that we can actually trust the words that they put into us, that we don't have to guess and try to hear God on our own. I thank you that there's reliable, loving people who operate under the anointing, and their word is trustworthy. Their word is trustworthy. They are good to us, and they are good. I believe the prophets, and I prosper. 2 Chronicles 20:20. I thank you, Lord. I thank you for your prophets. I am your servant, Lord. Prosper me. Nehemiah 1:11. I thank you that I don't just serve because it sounds good, but there's actual benefits, just like in a job. If it makes sense to pray for jobs because of its benefits, and then we sit and we settle and we base our hopes and our lives, we base our retirement, we base day one to the very end on these things, how much more is there benefit in serving our Lord? The God of heaven will prosper me, Nehemiah 2:20, and he is prospering me, and I thank you that it doesn't end here. I thank you that from here we have unlimited expansion and anointing because of all the new ideas and fresh wisdom being delivered to people who do listen. We live in the prosperity of the King. Jeremiah 23:5, and I thank you that it's our inheritance. Through your favor, I will be a prosperous person. Genesis 39:2. I thank you, Lord, that even though I don't understand how you make it happen, that was not the point. It's that we trust and obey, and that understanding comes through the experience. Lord, you have called me, and you will make my way prosperous. Isaiah 40:15. Don't do the things that you see in statistics that tell you that you'll be successful based on economy. Because economy has nothing to do with what God will do in your life. We don't make moves according to the stock or to our president. We make them according to our King. So don't get confused into thinking that we have to serve two masters. Satan is not the problem. It is money. It is either money or God. And we prosper so that we don't fall prey to the traps of what money may bring. I pray in secret, and you reward me openly. Matthew 6:6. And we'll pray openly. It does not matter. We don't do this for the wrong reasons. We do this because it has benefit in our life. We don't do it to make others feel good. We do it because there's evidence. Even if it was just one time, we've seen it work. And Lord, I pray that we press in to make it work continuously. I fast in secret, and you reward me openly. Matthew 6:18. I thank you for the discipline to be able to withhold all those things that the world tells you you need in order to sustain yourself. Because the truth is, as we press on, we have a greater experience that reveals to us we don't need what the world said we needed. You reward me because I diligently seek you. Hebrews 11:16. Diligently. It's not about every once in a while when we come into a bad place that we think it sounds good to pursue him, but that we do it in spite of how we feel.
Everyone is praying. Come on.
Lord, release the wealth of the wicked into my hands. Proverbs 13:22. Because us, the godly, can do so much more. What one could do with $1 million, we can make happen even with two. According to Jesus, because if one could be broken up just like the bread, imagine that. We will always have what we need. I see money being broken up like bread for everything that we need. Lord, bring me into a wealthy place. Psalm 66:12. And that wealthy place doesn't have to be the place where all the CEOs and business stuff is going on. Sometimes it's places just like this where we're doing what we're doing. And I thank you that this is a wealthy place. That this is the place where wealth starts and ends at. I give and it is given to me. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. Luke 6:38. We give, we receive. Some like to call it karma, but I call it Jesus, and it works. It works, and even those who can't admit that it's Jesus still admit that something's working. So I thank you that we have the knowledge to identify what it is, because there's power in identification. I thank you that we identify who it is that operates in us, and that we can call on him more than once in a while. Open the floodgates of heaven over my life, and I receive more than I have enough room to receive. Malachi 3:10. I thank you that we are so blessed that we can have the storehouse, but now we have to have other people have storehouses.
Brother, I just want to say, because you're exhorting as you're doing that, I want to say it is still Wednesday. So if you do have your offerings and tithes, just because we're doing the prayers, I want you to know that you can still bring it, because it's still a service that we're having right now while you finish up the prayers, because we have to pray some more. I want you to get your offerings and your tithes ready as he is praying over this, because your finances are receiving a fresh unction, you understand, to increase. So get your offerings ready, your tithes ready, and then bring them here as he's praying over. Come on, brother, just have to.
Open the floodgates of heaven over our lives, and I receive more than I have enough room to receive. Malachi 3:10. I thank you that the days of praying for just what we need, just enough, deciding what's enough to just be okay to live with, that's done. We think best. That we can't go higher in our thinking. We just expand in our dimensions of understanding. Let every hole in my bag be closed in the name of Jesus. Haggai 1:6. No more putting stuff in your pockets that was your blessing and it falling out and being left somewhere else. It's for you. We hold on to that tight. No more losing any loose change or anything like that. Rebuke the devourer for my sake. Malachi 3:11. I thank you that those things that have basically come against us and sought to eat everything that we have. We may not feel like we have enemies, but anything that's keeping you from your goal is an enemy. All nations will call me blessed, us blessed, and I will be delightful. I will be a delightful land. Malachi 3:12. I thank you that people are going to start being able to come to us, because not only because we have land enough to house them, but that we become a place where people can securely dwell, because us as people have developed ourselves in a way that people can really stand and know that we are sure, that they can trust. My gates are open continually that the forces of the nation can come into my life. Isaiah 60:11. I am in league with the stones of the field. Job 5:23. Let your showers of blessing come upon my life. Ezekiel 34:26. I thank you that there's showers, Lord, that we're covered from head to toe. That it starts at the head and goes down to the toes, but not a single part is neglected. That we can't run away. We can't run away from the rain that's happening here. Let my vats overflow. Joel 2:24. Let my barns be filled with plenty and my presses burst with new wine. Proverbs 3:10. I thank you. Command your blessings upon my storehouse. Deuteronomy 28:8. Let my barns be full and overflowing. Let my sheep bring forth thousands and ten thousands. Let my oxen be strong to labor. Psalm 144:13-14. The plowman overtakes the reaper in my life, and the treader of grapes, the sower of the seed. I live in continual harvest. Amos 9:13. Let my floor be full of wheat, and my vats overflow with wine and oil. Joel 2:24. Deal wondrously with me, and let me eat and be satisfied. Joel 2:26. Make peace within my border and fill me with the finest wheat. Psalm 147:14. Let me be filled with honey and the finest of wheat. Psalm 81:16. Lead me into the land flowing with milk and honey. Exodus 3:8. Bring me into a good land without scarceness and lack. Deuteronomy 8:9. Make all grace abound toward me, us, that we will have sufficiency in all things and abound to every good work. 2 Corinthians 9:8. Anoint our heads with oil and let our cups run over. Psalm 23:5. Let me have riches and honor in abundance. 2 Chronicles 18:1. Let the rock pour me out rivers of oil. Job 29:6. Let us dip our feet in oil. Deuteronomy 33:24. Let us see your heaps in our life. 2 Chronicles 31:8. I love wisdom. I inherit substance, and my treasures are filled. Proverbs 8:21. I received riches and honor, durable riches and righteousness. Proverbs 8:18. Bring honey out of the rock for me. Psalm 81:16. Let me eat the finest wheat. Psalm 147:14. Let my teeth be white with milk. Genesis 49:12. Wash my steps with butter. Job 29:6. Let me lay up gold as dust. Thank you, Lord. Job 22:24. Let us have plenty of silver and gold and all those things. Job 28:1. Let your river lead me to gold. Genesis 2:11-12. Let me inherit the land. Psalm 37:29. And I refuse to allow the angel of blessing to depart without blessing me. Genesis 2:6.
Come on, help me encourage him. Come on, come on, come on. That's what we call a mighty man of God. It may have taken a little while, but it's all right. It's his house too. Amen. I just want to make an announcement. Pastor Donald was saying that the square, I call it the machine, the debit card or credit card machine, we don't have it today. So if you wanted to give with your card, what is that buzzing sound? If you wanted to give with your card, please just write down your info on the envelope. If you need the envelope, come get it before we go on. We're just going to close very soon. But write the info on the envelope and they will be able to take care of you. Father, we thank you. Come on, come on. Come on, saints. When he's praying, that means you're praying too. That's why he's giving the scriptures, so that you can read the scriptures even where you are. Come on, saints. We have to know how to pray strategically. The glory is here to stay. The glory's here to stay. Come on, worship Him. Lord, we worship Your God. We lift up our voices. We honor You. Adonai, Adonai. For all You're doing in this place, in all over the earth. Adonai. Come on, worship Him where you are. And for those of you who are watching us, connect with this anointing. My, there is no distance in the spirit. What is here can reach you where you are. Come on, wherever you are, if you're feeling sick, if you're feeling weak, if you have a need, take those hands and commend those hands to do the work. Lay those hands upon your own self and say, I'm healed, I'm delivered, I'm set free. And not only set free, but I'm made free. This thing can no longer come against me. Come on, come on, come on. Say, pray and encourage them. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Take the oil and anoint your children. Take and anoint everywhere around their house. Command the presence of God to stay. Say, God, I made this house clean for You. Come and take over. Come and take over. Make it your own, God. And if you want to sow as well, you can always do that. But come on, saints, let's worship. Kaye, kaye, kaye. Kaye, 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 kaye. And don't forget, we have this Friday, we have a praise and prayer shut-in. God, we're going to come here. We're going to take it up a notch. Amen. It's been good that we've been coming at 7 p.m. How about just laying on the altar all throughout the night? You think if you deny yourself and say, God, I'm leaving my little nice room to come into Your house to pray, not for myself, but for those out there, for someone who's weak. Because yes, you will be praying for yourself as well, I'm sure of it. But when you come here and you say, Aya, ah, 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 say, no, God, they will not die in that hospital bed. You say, no, God, my child will have everything they need. I will not raise my kids alone. There's a lot of things. You say, God, no, the people of God will not be on welfare. There's a lot of prayer requests to be brought before the Lord. A lot of petitions. This is a time to pray and say, God, I'm standing in the gap. And look after me too. We will be here all night from 11 p.m. all the way to 6 a.m. I believe we have some tea. I don't know if we have something like that, like tea to keep people up for coffee. If not, I'm coming to your house and taking all your coffees, and I'm going to make them available in this place. And some little biscuit. I know Brother Ethan is going to provide all of that. I'm just kidding. He's opened his arms. I receive. That's right. But God is going to supply you with supernatural strength. Because if God said, come and spend more time with me, He knows exactly why. Saints, and the Lord bless your obedience. If you have any testimony at all. See, I know that God will not have us to do this unless He's doing something in your life. I want to open the floor 5 minutes only. Because I know there's someone here who wants to testify. When we say testimonies, I'm not talking about you getting a big house. I'm talking about your life being changed. Your prayer life going up, because your testimonies is what edifies the body of Christ. If you have your testimony and you want to share it quickly and you want to give God thanks, come and share it. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, we thank You for the works that You're doing in this place. Thank you.
So anyone who mocks it, if I mock it, I will not be forgiven. That's why we honor it. We humble ourselves. You didn't have to do it. You could have just left us where we were. But you said, I'm going to come and I'm going to spend 21 days of intimacy with them. And take them to another level in me. You will not mock it. And if we have said anything outside of this church, we ask that God, you forgive us for our ignorance. Bless the works of your hands. Because the Holy Spirit is tender, y'all. He's gentle. And God said that anything we do against him, we will not be forgiven. That's what I know in this house. We honor that. We honor the word. We have testimony. We do. All right, let us encourage her. Just stay prayerful.
I just want to thank God openly in front of everybody. Just because this 21 days of prayer has been absolutely amazing. And when we first started, I really didn't think that I was going to be able to commit to coming all the time. I know we all have very busy schedules, but every single day it has been more and more of just a joy. This is the only thing I want to do in my day. When I wake up in the morning, my day goes seamlessly, and it just brings me here. And God has definitely been changing me. He's been changing my life in the way of my relationship with him. And I definitely encourage everybody to come to just, you know, he'll just give you a new intimacy, a deeper relationship with him. I just am developing an intimacy with him that I've never had in my life before, you know, and I've always, you know, since I started coming to this church, you know, I've loved on him, and I've known he loves me, you know, but it's different now. It's personal. He shows me things and he speaks to me, and I feel a love from him that I've just never had. And I know that he is everything for me, that he is the one that I can turn to for everything and anything. And if nobody else in the world is there for me, he is. So just give your whole heart to him, and he answers, and he'll show up for you.
Come on, saints. I want you. No. Come back here. I want you to begin to learn this thing. Whenever someone testifies, you cover them. Stretch forth your hands. The enemy likes to attack people when they testify. Why? I think people, a lot of people don't like testifying. Not that they don't have testimonies. But it's a battle. The Bible says in Revelation that you will overcome him with your testimonies and the blood of the Lamb. So he knows he can't fight against the blood. But he can't stop you from testifying. Let's cover her. I've had stories of people that testified in backlash. But you will not be ignorant of Satan's devices. I'm here to expose it all. I'm here to open your eyes. So pray for her. Say, God, we cover this young lady. That you will take her from glory to glory. We envelop her, oh God, with the blood of the Lamb. Father, everywhere she goes, she will be your mouthpiece, Lord. She will speak. She will have testimonies after testimonies of your goodness in the land. God, she will never lack what to say, oh God. We thank you that gifts on the inside of her is being activated. God, we thank you, oh God, that everything, oh God, she touches will prosper. We thank you that no weapon that is formed against her shall be able to prosper. And every tongue that rises itself against this young lady, she will have the power and the authority to condemn it. Because death and life is in the power of the tongue. We thank you that she's a mighty woman of God. And she comes to a house that is power packed. The glory of God is all over her. In the name of Jesus. Amen. And that's how you do it all the time. You want to testify too? Come. Come on, encourage her.
Thank you. I thank God for this opportunity of the 21 days. I am not sure if you've ever heard of the terminology of being born again, but I have been reactivated. So I heard about the 21 days of prayer. I forget, maybe the first day or the second day after it had already started. I get up at 4:45 in the morning and I get home at 10 o'clock at night. And I work 6 or 7 days a week in a project that I'm working on right now. I commute an hour to work and I thought, oh, that's great. I'm going to make it to at least 2 days. But I came to the fourth day and I'm on like a light switch and never going back. And so I just want to encourage whoever you are, even if you have to take, you know, get an airline ticket to come here, it's worth it. And it's just like Nicole said, it's a greater intimacy and, you know, it helps me through the day. It helps me, you know, just to be close to at a new level of intimacy with Christ. So it's awesome. It's amazing. I thank God for this opportunity.
What part of we are going breaking patterns? See, they are coming. More are coming. I told you, when you follow the word, you cannot go wrong. We don't follow man's formula. It doesn't work, y'all. Trust me. You can come up with your own plan. I guarantee it will fail. But God's word is forever settled in heaven. He is bound to this word. He himself is saying, I'm bound to my own word. Come on. Father, we cover her from the crown of her head to the sole of her feet. And whatever it is that she was looking for from you, she has received it, oh God. Because your word says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all of its righteousness, then all these things shall be added. Father, thank you, Lord God, that your spirit is moving on the inside and doing a work, oh God. Father, I thank you that there would not be a day where she would not give you praise and glory for who you are in her life. Complete restoration. Heaven open now in Jesus' name. And I cover your going out and coming in Jesus' name. Supernatural strength. Come on. Amen. But you don't wait for me to pray alone. Amen. That's why we have prayer. Come on, baby. That's why we have prayer meetings every day. You have to learn to pray for yourself and other people. Not just rely on the leaders. Because that's what they're doing this. So everyone can know. Isn't this my princess? I don't even know her name, y'all. Karina, let me get back in the spirit. Yeah, all right.
Okay, so I'm really shy. So I haven't been coming to the 21 days of prayer, but I will starting tomorrow. Despite it, God still blesses me. I woke up this morning, I had like $5 in my bank account. I have like a million things that I have to buy, like the cat needs food, the dog needs food, I need things. I'm like, oh my God. And I was starting to stress out, and just through continuously coming to church and being taught to meditate on the word instead, I was like, okay, God, you said that you will provide, you know, through the kingdom of heaven. It's all right. So I put that negative thought in the back of my mind and proceeded with my morning. And I go, my car was crashed and I got it fixed, and I go to drop off the rental and pick up my car, and the guy goes, write her a check. And I was like, write me a check for what? And I was like, okay, thanks. He wrote me a check, and then I deposited it into my account, and I was like, thank you, because I didn't know how I was going to eat. I didn't know how I was going to get. I didn't know anything, but he provided. He provided for me. That's my testimony.
Come on, let us stretch forth our hands. Let's say the same way that check came in, that there will be many more. This woman, didn't we just pray for her a few days ago? Didn't we just pray for you a few days ago? How have you been feeling ever since? Great. She is so precious. She really just want to cry. Y'all stand next to her. She's so God in the spirit. Father, we thank you that this young lady, oh God, is the head and not the tail. Above only and never beneath, oh God. We thank you, oh God, that her image is completely restored. God, she has, yes, just like they're coming to touch her, God. She has, come on, somebody sow into her. Sow something into her. Sow some money. I don't like seeing this. Come on. devil, I break the curse of poverty over your life. Levo soto robo koba shete. I thank you, God, that people will look for her to give her a job, oh God. And until she's ready, oh God, to own her own business, oh God. I thank you, oh Lord God, that her identity is in you, Lord. God, I thank you, just like the church has come around her, oh God, she will have good people around her, oh God. Even outside of this church, oh God, she's loved. She's loved. She's loved. And nothing and no one can ever change. And if anyone raise a word against this young lady, oh God, may you arise and scatter those enemies in the name of Jesus. We seal up her testimony, oh God, and we seal up everything that's on the inside. We cover her going out and coming in, Father, in the name of Jesus. If anyone else wants to testify, last person, please, by all means, rush. Come on, woman of God. We love you, princess. Yay. More comes to you now. Love on her. Yes, man of God. Come on, come on, come on. I'm waiting for you, man of God. I'm right here. I'm struck by the Holy Ghost. I'm just like too drunk. I can't get up. Come on.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Yes. Go ahead. Yes.
Oh, he's gonna sit like smart man.
I'm gonna sit down because what I'm gonna say is for everybody sitting down. 5 minutes. I'm not going to say my testimony. What I'm going to say was God do it for my life. Okay? My life was a mess. Even though that I had a fake smile, God was working at me. As you know, my marriage was going down the toilet. I was heading the woman that I've been with her since 1975. I wasn't respecting her. I was mistreating her, not touching her, but I was dropping off love. And we had a few months to go either way. But Mama and Dad came to my rescue. And when she sat next to me and she says that I had to get into the Word, I took that, and every time she went to work, I got into the Word, listened to it, coming over here. But every time I came from service here, I said, I wish there was more time, because Sunday wasn't enough, Saturday wasn't enough, and Wednesday wasn't enough. Until I heard the 21 day. I get up at 4 o'clock in the morning to go to work. I go to Mass. I get up 2:30, I go home. I used to take a nap, I don't take a nap now. I feel energized. And you said something that really, really touched me, okay? I want to start my business, my wife wants to start her business. But because I broke my arm, I says, you know, I can't do what I was doing before. But for some reason or another, Mama prayed with my arm, and now I can move it. Okay? So little by little, working here in the church, working everywhere, I said, I can do my business now. There was one puzzle that I needed, a truck. And as I was trying to get the truck, the devil was getting in the way. He said, it's going to cost too much money. But I went to a place, and I'm getting one Monday. And the boss helping team was that everything that has the kingdom, it works for you. My wife opened a business to take care of all people with the kingdom name on it. My business is Kindle Electric and Plumbing, and the truck is in the way. Because I want to feed the house that saved my marriage. Now me and my wife looked at each other and it's like we met yesterday. Okay? We are alone now because the kids are going. We're planning a cruise for our anniversary. And when she goes to work, I go in the room and I talk men some cry. But I did cry. As soon as I started talking to God, he got into me. And I was tired because I work with chemicals. And I was coming home all charged. My wife always make a cup of coffee for me. She said, "You gonna take a nap?" I said, "No, I feel good. I just want to spend more time with her, talking to her, because she works every night." But she told me something that I didn't know for a long time. To love Jesus before I love her. Okay? And it works. It works. Because God gave us that woman not to abuse her, not to mistreat her, to treat her like a queen. And that's my queen. Okay? Thank you.
Come on, let's pray for him. Come on, everybody stand up.
Y'all forgive me. I am drunk. If I stand up, I'll fall. So please forgive me. I know myself. It's better I stay seated. Let us stretch forth our hands. Father, we thank you for this vessel that has made himself available to you, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, every wound, oh God, on the inside. It's being healed. Hallelujah. You are kissing every part of him. All the years that the enemy stole from you. Just like Brother Ethan was reading. The years the locusts have eaten. The canker worm. The palmer worm. The caterpillar. Everything comes back to you. We seal this testimony. And we declare and decree as God's people that there will be more to come upon you. That the anointing of God will rain upon your head. It will go from your head and it will touch everyone that is connected to you. Everyone that comes under you, everyone connected to you, that anointing will work. Your business will flourish. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Anyone that tries to come and act funny, oh God, we thank you the angel of the Lord will chase them out. We thank you that this region will know who Brother Angel, that's your last name, what's your last name? Camacho.
Yeah, pray for me.
Brother Angel Camacho is blessed. And the blessings of the Lord makes one rich and added no sorrow. There's no sorrow connected to your blessing. In the name of Jesus. Okay, I can take one more. Just one more. I know one more. I knew it. See, I was telling the Lord, these people got to go home, Jesus. Say one more. Come on, Tanya. It's okay. The Holy Ghost got the camera. Oh, yeah, Sarah got the camera. I depend so much on the Holy Spirit. I promise you, it becomes like my friend. Holy Ghost. This, not that I'm taking him for granted or I play with him. No. But he becomes so much, come this side so they can see you. He becomes so much a part of me. That I just begin to talk about him all the time. I have no one else. He's my first. And my, oh, she's sitting too. Look at that glory. The glory, the rest is upon you. Come on, share it.
I haven't been here consistently because I had to work. When I could, I watched it on TV. And I told people about it and they watched it too. But last night while I was at work, this young lady who has a son, he's about a teenager, and she said she's getting anxiety. And I'm one who wakes up at 3 o'clock in the morning, and all of a sudden I hear my neighbors, different things going on, and I pray. But this lady came over to me, and I said, well, I bring her to some books that were anxiety, and I said, but this isn't for you. And she started crying. Every time she looked at me, she started crying. And I told her, and I can't talk about Jesus the way I want to, but in the ways I was showing her to draw. I was taking her to puzzles, but I said, you know, you're looking for to help your son with stress, and you're thinking that he's hiding things from you. I said, but you have to get yourself straight. You have to release everything inside of you and give it away. Take a deep breath, eat some things that are healthy for you. And I wanted to say more on that subject, I gave her the books that she was looking for, but she kept crying. And I said, my coworkers are looking at me funny, but I said, you know, you have to look for love. You have to look for something else, something outside, something that brings you peace and calmness and love. And if you can find those changes in yourself, your son, even though he's 17, will watch what you do, and he will find those changes in him. And I walked away after I gave her the things that she was getting, and she brought some more things that I suggested to her, and she's still crying. And then I heard her laugh. She started laughing. And, you know, she was fine. She was looking at puzzles, and she said, oh, this one. And she started laughing. And then when she came up to, because I went up to cash after that to cash her out, because they sent me up to cash, and she was the perfect person in line for me. And she said, I just want to thank you. And it wasn't me. I couldn't say anything else. But I'm telling you this because that has happened many times to me. And I don't know why people cry when I talk to them. But I just thank God that if it wasn't for Mama, He opens my heart to say something, to love these people, to where I can't say the normal things I want to say to them, but I can say that Jesus loves you, or in another way, by my touch, by my voice, by the way I say hi. And I'm not always like that. I'm gonna not tell you the truth. My legs are hurting. I've been standing for 4 hours, and you know, but when she was there, that's all I could think of. I spent like an hour telling her that God loved her in a different way and showing her the little things that he could do to make her happy, to bring peace to her heart, so she wasn't overwhelmed by that was going on around her.
Hallelujah. For the sake of time, ago, pray for her and wrap this part up of the service. Father, we just thank you for your daughter. She is blessed. She is an evangelist because that's her desire. Say, those who hunger and thirst for you shall be filled, according to Matthew 5. We thank you, Jesus, that she has found a home here on earth, oh God, where you dwell and where you are molding and shaping her so that she can look more and more like you. We just thank you, oh God, that in this house there will be no fear to evangelize, no fear to be bold for Jesus. There will be no other thing that will be raised up except for the Lord. We thank you that her testimony is sealed with the blood. We thank you that her hands prospers. And we thank you, God, that you're restoring everything. Her youth back to her. She's strong and she is mighty in God. Double for her trouble in Jesus' name. Amen. We thank God for your life. And we just seal every prayer and every request. We seal up everything that has taken place. Everything that has taken place. The good things that the Lord has done in this house, it's been sealed with the blood. In Jesus' name, you are blessed. Tomorrow we meet again at 7 p.m. No accidents, no death. Think about the enemy has been trying. People have been escaping some accidents. And every time I make mention of that, I know why. Because you have to understand, when you engage yourself as an army of God in spiritual warfare, heaven will back you up, but there are spiritual forces that will try to come against you, but not one person will fall for the enemy's traps. I bind fear off of you, doubt.
rebellion, retaliation. Go and spread the news. Invite people to come. We are closing this thing very soon. Today's day 15. For all of you that joined us, we love you. You have been strong in the Lord. Tomorrow is day 16. It's almost the end of it. I hope you have been enjoying this. Invite people so that you're not just benefiting, but somebody else is. Even children. Train them up in the ways of the Lord so that when they're older, they would not depart. Amen. Bring the crackheads. Bring every person. Even those who said no. Yes, I said it. I did. No, I mean, well, God's love that's in this house will perfect everything in your life. I believe it. I believe the love that has been established in this place will bring everything into perfect alignment through the word and through power of the prayers of the righteous. Bye. Go home.